Hello there, good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London and Robin Brundle is joining us here, the Chairman of Technology Minerals, the Battery Economy Specialist, because you've opened your first laboratory suite at your new battery processing facility there in Wolverhampton. So we're going to learn about all why you've done it and what it will be used for. So a very good afternoon to Robin.
A very good afternoon to you, Katie. Yes, indeed. Well, Technology Minerals PLC is the first listed UK company focusing on creating a sustainable and circular economy for battery metals. And as we've reported previously, we're very, very close to opening our first lithium-ion and our lead acid plants in the Midlands here in the UK. And of course, they're recycling. So through the Recyclus Group, we're recycling both of those sciences of batteries. And we felt that it was very important to have, you know, what is a significant investment, several hundreds of thousands of pounds here, into a laboratory to make sure that we've got consistent performance for the outputs. So what does that mean in reality? It means for our lead product from the traditional lead recycling, that we'll be able to very accurately measure the content of the sulfur and also the lead element within the lead paste that we produce from the recycling. So that, again, we can assure clients that they're going to be getting a consistent product. And also for on the lithium ion, as you know, we're first to market with the lithium ion recycling and a problem solver here in the UK for many sectors. But it also means that the laboratory will be able to test what we've described before as the black mass. So the powder that's got the four key metals in, the laboratory will be able to measure that black mass to make sure that we've got a consistent product coming off the back end as well. So we can measure product on the way in, we can measure product on the way out, and just basically fully understand the business and give our customers assurances that we've got that consistency going through.
Mm-hmm. And how would you say that this fits in with your strategy as a company?
Well, it's very important to us to make sure that that as we roll out each of the plants, so we've got plant one and plant two going live in February this year, i.e. next month. And then we have plant three and four being commissioned at the end of this year, beginning of next year again. So to have the laboratory and to make sure we've got that consistency will give the customers confidence to take more and more volume from us as we go forwards and rolling out the UK, European and global strategy that we have through to 2027.
Let's talk about the market itself and how you feel that you fit into it.
Well, on the lead side, as we've said before, it's a mature market. It's a 100 odd year old industry. But our fit is that our plant that we have is industrializing what's previously been a very manual process. So traditionally, lead acid batteries are either burnt through incinerators, worse still, they're sent to landfill, or they've been a very manual process. So our plant's being commissioned in the last week of January on the lead side, ready to go into production in anger during February. It's going to be doing 16,000 tons of lead acid batteries, where we capture 100% of everything we put in at the front end. We capture, separate, and put to good purpose out of the other end. On the lithium ion, again, as we've said, you know, the UK doesn't yet have an industrialized capability for all five sciences of the lithium ion batteries. And our process is unique. We've got the IP on both the process and also the plant that we've designed here in the UK by a UK company working with us. And we're able to put all five of those sciences into our machine in any combination at any time and safely recycle them, producing the black mass at the back end, which then gets separated into its four key ingredients. And the ideal aim is to then go back into putting those ingredients back into making new batteries and genuinely creating the circular economy. So we feel that we're cutting right through the greenwash that some people describe out there at the present time. We absolutely support the COP26 agenda, and we believe that we're a great news story for British industry in really peeling back that greenwash, because we're actually doing some doing here.
Doing some doing. I like that. Robin, thank you very much indeed. The chairman there from Technology Minerals here on Proactive.
Thank you, Katie.